கட்டமைப்புக்கு வரலாற்று துறையின் சார்பிலே பேராசிரியர் கருணானந்தம் அவர்கள் அவருடைய பணிப்பொழிவு அவர்கள் விவேகானந்த கல்லூரியிலே பல ஆண்டுகளாக வரலாற்று துறையிலே பேராசிரியராக இருந்து பேராசிரியராக மட்டுமில்லாமல் ஒரு போராளியாகவும் உரிமைக்காக தொடர்ந்து இருந்து ஓய்வு பெற்ற பிறகு ஒரு சுதந்திர பறவையாகவே அவர் தங்கி வீட்டில் முடங்கிடாமல் தன்னுடைய கருத்துக்கள் இந்த பல்கலைக்கழகத்திலே இருக்கிற மாணவர்களுக்கெல்லாம் தலைமுறை தலைமுறையாக அது பயன்பட வேண்டும் என்ற எண்ணத்தோடு தான் மிகப்பெரிய ஒரு செல்வந்தர் இல்லை என்று சொன்னாலும் கூட தன்னுடைய சேமிப்பிலே ஒரு பகுதியை ஒதுக்கி அதை பொதுநலத்துக்கு பயன்பட வேண்டும், மாணவ சமுதாயமும் ஆசிரியர் பெருமக்களும் முறையே வெளியிலே தெரிந்து கொள்ள முடியாத பல பாடத்திலே தெரிந்து கொள்ள முடியாத செய்திகளை இந்த பல்கலைக்கழகத்தினுடைய ஆய்வு சொற்பொழிவுகள் மூலம் ஒரு தெரிந்து கொள்ள வேண்டும் என்ற நோக்கத்தோடு ஒரு அறக்கட்டளையை அவர்கள் இங்கே உருவாக்கினார். எஸ் கிரியேட் இந்த நெட்டோமன் அதனுடைய ஒரு பெரிய வாய்ப்பிலேதான் இந்த சொற்பொழிவுகள் தொடர்ந்து நடைபெறுகின்றன. அந்த வகையில இந்த சிறப்பான சொற்பொழிவை நடத்துவதற்கு இன்றைக்கு தகுதிமிக்க ஒரு பேராசிரியர் ப்ரொஃபசர் அமிரின் தேஷ்பாண்டே, அவர் மோஸ்ட் ரெஸ்பெக்ட்ஃபுல் ப்ரொஃபசர் டிபார்ட்மெண்டல் ஹிஸ்டரி ஃபேக்கல்டி ஆஃப் சோசியல் சயின்சஸ் டெல்லி யூனிவர்சிட்டி இஸ் கைண்ட் டு அக்செப்ட் அவர் இன்விடேஷன் and coming and in the thought-provoking speech, a research speech which will be very commendable, which will be recorded, and later on sir, we will be having the privilege of not only hearing your speech but also recording the speech. This goes to the whole world through this way, and we will have to record it, and if possible certainly your address, your endowment address, research address will be brought in as a book, special book on Periyar. How is the review of why Periyar's scintillating work, very pioneering work about women, why were women against slavery in this country, in our country. These are very thought-provoking, original thinker, from an original thinker, a great social revolutionary Tade Periyar. We were not born when he has returned that. He was such a great pioneer. அப்படிப்பட்ட ஒருவருடைய உரையை இந்த ஆற்றுவருக்கு டெல்லி பல்கலைக்கழகத்தை விட்டு சென்னை பல்கலைக்கழகத்திற்கு வந்து அவருக்கு எவ்வளோ வெல்கம் இந்த லேண்ட் ஆஃப் தமிழ்நாடு, லேண்ட் ஆஃப் பெரியார், லேண்ட் ஆஃப் அடுத்தபடியாக சிறப்பான வகையிலே இந்த ஏற்பாட்டை செய்திருக்கக்கூடிய நம்முடைய பாராட்டுக்குரிய பல்வேறு செய்திகள் இவைகளெல்லாம் எழுந்திரிச்சலடித்து இந்த பல்கலைக்கழகத்திலே மிக சிறப்பாக முத்திரை பயிர் கொண்டு வரக்கூடிய நம்முடைய அன்பிற்கும் பாராட்டுவதற்குரிய கடவுள் உழைப்பாளியாக சிந்தனையாக மாணவர்களால் மிகவும் நேசிக்கப்படக்கூடிய ஒரு பேராசிரியராக இருக்கக்கூடிய பேராசிரியர் எஸ் எஸ் சுந்தரம் அவர்களே இந்த நிகழ்ச்சியிலே சிறப்பாக வந்து கலந்து கொண்டு இங்கே தான் இந்த உரையை தான் அளித்தது பயன்படுகிறதா என்று ஒவ்வொரு ஆண்டும் கவனத்தோடு அளிக்கின்றவர்கள் பெருந்திசையிலே இருப்பார்கள். எண்டோமென்ட்ஸ் வில் பி கிரியேட்டட் பட் தி கிரியேட்டர் ஆஃப் தி எண்டோமென்ட் வில் நாட் லிசன் whether it is going on every year, whether it is being usefully done to be purposeful, whether the purpose is completely served, this is a very rare phenomenon. But Professor Karnananda is very particular that we that this is used in a very rightful way. Selecting people who are worthy of delivering those kind of nature. So on this behalf, we thank you profusely. We welcome you. That is very much. This is one of my very nice. அந்த முறை நம்முடைய நந்தி உரை போல இருக்கக்கூடிய டாக்டர் பேராசிரியர் எஸ் கேகல்வி திரு லட்சுமணன் அவர்களே, இந்த நிகழ்வுக்கு வருகை வந்திருக்கக்கூடிய பெருமைக்குரிய அவருடைய மேலாள் நீதியரசர் அன்பிற்குரிய ஐயா ஜஸ்டிஸ் அக்பர் அலி அவர்களே, இந்த பல்கலைக்கழகத்திற்கு அவர்கள் ஒரு வகையிலே ஒரு அதிகாரத்துடன் உள்ளவர். ஆனால் இப்படிப்பட்ட ஒரு சிறப்பு நிகழ்ச்சிகள் எல்லாம் வருகிற போது தவறாமல் வந்து அவர்களுக்கு வேறு பணி பதினொன்றை பணிக்கு இருக்கிறது. இருந்தாலும் இங்கே வர வேண்டும் என்பதற்காக வந்திருக்கிறார். இது ஒரு அற்புதமான ஒரு நிகழ்ச்சி. இதுவரும் மாணவர்கள் மட்டுமல்ல, பேராசிரியர் மட்டுமல்ல, நீதியரசர்களே இங்க வந்து பெரியார் என்ன அவருடைய உரையை பற்றி கேட்க வேண்டும், அவரை பற்றி பேசுகிறார் என்று சொல்கிற நேரத்தில் கவிஞர் கண்ணதாசன் அவர்கள் ஒரு வரியிலே அழகாக பெரியாருக்கு என்ன தகுதி என்று சொல்கிற நேரத்துல நீதிமன்ற நீதிக்கும் நீதி சொல்வார், அவர் தேவையற்று வளர்ந்ததெல்லாம் நிகழ்த்தி வைப்பார் என்று எடுத்து வருகிறார். அவரை நீதிமன்ற நீதிக்கும் நீதி சொன்னார் என்பதற்காகத்தான் நீதிபதி அவர்களே அவருடைய கருத்துக்களை தேஷ்பாண்டே போன்றவர்கள் சொல்கிற நேரத்தில் கேட்க வேண்டும் என்பதற்காக இங்கு சிறப்பாக வந்திருக்கிறார்கள் அவர் நிறைவேற்றிய நீதியரசர் அவர்களே. அதே போல மேனாள் நம்முடைய பாரதிதாசன் பல்கலைக்கழகத்தினுடைய துணைவேந்தர் ஆற்றல் மிகு பேராசிரியர் டாக்டர் ஜெகதீஷ் அவர்களே, மற்றும் ஏராளமாக இருக்கிற பேராசிரியர் பெருமக்களே, காலத்தின் அறிவியர்களை அனைவரையும் குறித்ததாக நீங்கள் கருதி கொள்ள வேண்டும் என்ற அன்போடு வேண்டிக் கொண்டு இந்த நிகழ்ச்சியிலே கலந்து கொண்டு சிறப்பிக்கின்ற துணை பெருமக்களே, மாடர்ன் நேஷனலிஸ்ட் பத்திரிகையினுடைய நிர்வாக ஆசிரியர் தாழ்மை சகோதரர் குமரேசன் அவர்களே, மற்றும் மாணவர் செல்வங்களே, பேராசிரியர் மக்களே, உங்கள் எல்லோருக்கும் அன்பான வணக்கம். இட் இஸ் மை ப்ரவுட் பிரிவிலேஜ் அண்ட் ஆனர் அண்ட் பிளஷர் டு பி பிஃபோர் யூ அபவுட் இன்ட்ரடியூசிங் தி பெரியார் தாட்ஸ் ஆன் விமன் அண்ட் எஸ்பெஷலி ஆஃப் ஆஃப் தி வேர்ல்ட் பாப்புலேஷன் வி ஆல் நோ இதாவது எனி ஜெனரல் வைரஸ் is a factor that human population, human population is half of it, 15%. But how far they are given the rights, how far they are enjoying the rights. But one great difference between the other parts of the globe and our country is very, very noteworthy, very obvious. Not only obvious, it is injurious to society. One may agree with me, not, but it's a fact. It's a bitter fact, bitter truth. Because in our country, we are religiously divided, but the globe is there. But in our religion, the majority religion, how far they recognize the human form, whether they are human beings, they recognize, this is a question raised. The basic thing is why women enslaved. This was a question long time posed by Periyar and answered by him. It was that of a shock that time because nobody has dared enough to expose these kind of social injuries that have been caused to the women of half of the population were denied their rights. But basically, even though the women were discriminated even in the West, but there is a special class of discrimination in our country because of the religion they are born. They are not choosing it, but they were born because my parents belonged to this religion, this caste and classes. It has been done to us. But I don't want to take much of time. I want to give an introduction there. So what is the difference? Why Periyar was motivated to write about this work? Even in our country, even in our times, the modern times, even in the 21st century, there is the practice our human food instead of fighting for their rights as human rights. Because they are concerned, we are all concerned human beings. But whether they are really considered as human beings and given the same rights, this is a question. This is a good question. This is a real tough question. Because we all know, even today, they are struggling to go home. The child is struggling to be born from the home. Because they are not born. பல நேரங்களிலே உங்களுக்கு தெரியும் தமிழ்நாட்டில் இடங்கள்ல பல பிரச்சனைகள் இருக்கின்றன. நான் ஒரு முறை லண்டன் பிபிசிக்கு பேட்டி கொடுத்தேன். ஆனந்தி என்ற ஒரு அம்மையார், அவர் ஈழத்தில் பிறந்தவர், அந்த லண்டன்ல அங்கே இருக்கிறார். திராவிட கழகம் உங்களுடைய இயக்கம் சமூக சீர்திருத்தம் நல்ல காரியங்கள் பெரியாருடைய தலைமையில எல்லாத்தையும் பெரியார் பள்ளியார் ஒரு கேள்விக்கு நீங்க பதில் சொல்லணும். என்ன சொன்னா, உங்கள் தொழிலே தமிழ்நாட்டிலே கூட இவ்வளவு வளர்த்திருக்கிற இயக்கத்தில் இருக்கக்கூடிய தமிழ்நாட்டிலே கூட பல இடங்களிலேயே விஸ்வபட்டி போன்ற இடங்களிலே அந்த பகுதிகளிலே தர்மபுரியினுடைய சில மாவட்டங்களிலே சேல பகுதிகளிலே குழந்தைகள் பிறப்பதற்கு முன்னாலேயே அவர்களுக்கு அது பெண் குழந்தையாக இருந்தால் பிறக்கக்கூடாது. சொல்லக்கூடிய அளவுக்கு இருக்கிறதே இந்த குழந்தைகளை கொல்லக்கூடிய அளவுக்கு இப்பட்ட சொல்லக்கூடிய அளவுக்கு வெளியே வந்து குழந்தைகளை கொள்வதற்கு பதிலாக உள்ளேயே கர்ப்பத்திலேயே குழந்தைகளை கொல்லக்கூடிய அளவுக்கு முன்னாலேயே போராட்டத்தோடு பிறந்து வரக்கூடிய ஒரு இனமாக நம்முடைய நாட்டு பெண்கள் இருப்பது மிகப்பெரிய வேதனையாகவும் பெரியாரை பற்றி காரணம் Because of his humanism, because of his self-respect, because of his rationalism, he wanted to have a human approach to every problem. That's an original thinker. அப்படிப்பட்ட ஒரு சூழ்நிலையிலே மிக தெளிவாக அவர்களுடைய சிந்தனை ஆணும் பெண்ணும் எதற்காக டிஸ்கிரிமினேட் பண்ண வேண்டும்? Why the women and men are discriminated? And more or less, even among men, there is discrimination, there is a different pattern because of the caste system. But when we get in the self-respect movement, that they really are the great political teacher, social revolutionary, he was telling, no, if you consider the women, are they really human beings? No, they are being dehumanized. Because what? They have not been child. Been children? No. On the other hand, pet animals. Their pet animals are enjoying more rights than the pet children. If they born as human, this is a very bitter truth. Whether you accept it or not, today you might have some kind of freedom. But tomorrow, what will happen? Because of Saradhara Dharma, because of the various Manudharma, because they have been dehumanized. According to Manudharma, nobody could deny, because three people want to be Manudharma to be replaced in the position of Indian constitution written by Dr. Ambedkar and Baba Saheb. They are very eagerly awaiting to replace Manudharma. All women are considered to be Namo Sutra. What is called Namo Sutra means equivalent to Sutra. And they don't have any right to read, write, and arithmetic. All human rights are being denied. This is the position. That is why they have completely given a treatment, a discriminatory treatment. That is why they really are was very particular and வெரி தாட் ப்ரோவோக்கிங்லி ஹி ஆஸ்க்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் பெண்ணே அடிமையானாள் why were women enslaved you see in those times some 90 years back he has dealt with all the problems now it has gone in various languages which our main speaker is going to elaborate all these things under this chapter first chastity another is valour and chastity third is love the right to divorce remarriage is not wrong prostitution the plight of widows property rights birth control masculinity must be destroyed by women's spirit all these things so Periyar's thinking is very original and one thing which is very unique about Periyar is Periyar's original thinking was shaped not by any research not by entering into any libraries not by going even like Buddha and tree and all these things but he was an original thinker he was cultured self-cultured and whoever he experiences in his life he had learned and he formed the moment that necessitated to start the self-respect moment the first aim is that should be equality among all human beings not only equality women must be not only be equal to men there should be no gender bias this is the problem but more than equality next step is after getting equality that is only a stepping stone they must get empowered this is the idea of career empowered because of education was denied to them property rights were denied to them even they are not the owners of their bodies people that situation they would not accept so because of this moment because of this social moment because of this kind of revolutionary movement even Maharashtra like Jodhpur Pune and Savitribai Phule was the one of the earlier people to start a school for women all these things were there but in our country partly you have to know when children were born in northern India particularly in Banaras and other areas completely the human child baby was thrown into the Ganges the then British government brought a separate act to prohibit being in block and put recently also father has completely given a law in this in West Bengal people completely human child was destroyed and the infanticide was killed and thrown into the fields. Professor Satyanathaya, everybody knows Professor Satyanathaya was my professor when he studied in Annamalai University. And he has written an authoritative book on Indian history. There he mentions 19th century, even in Calcutta, West Bengal and other area, when human children was there, and they were completely killing them by going into the fields, into the Ganges, into other parts of all this. They don't have the right to be. This is important. So they don't have right to be born, right to bond, right to live. They don't have it because they are not equivalent to men. This is crucial. Number eight. But today we are talking about. இன்னைக்கு a male to the mother, and the mother, they will tell, no, the mother will tell if the boy, that they will, mother will bag a girl, because they will join with both of them. But they won't tell the same thing to other people. So, by that, the astrology is driving his business, that's all. But you say it is a mathematics, but that is not the case. It was science. They and their go, but our next partner who we carry on. Go on, scan, but we are going to put our pair. Now they have brought a separate act. Well, the center of the Ilkaya, the Naraka would be a very sort of another money star, and to be a people out of Kurma. After our partner, we would be able to say the Ilkaya. They are the other one. பொதுமை இருக்கு அதுதான் ஆதாரம். ஆதாரபூர்வமாக மிக முக்கியமாக இருக்கக்கூடிய வாய்ப்பு. எனவே பிறற்றோருக்கே போராடி பிறக்கிற ஒரு சமூகமா இருக்கிறது பெண்கள் சமூகம், அதுதான் மிக முக்கியம். பிறக்கிறது போராடணும், அதுக்கு விட நம்ம பிறந்த உடனே எப்படி இருந்திருக்கிறாங்கன்னா நம்ம நாட்டில் என்ன பெண்களையே ஆண்கள் சொல்றது கூட இல்லை. பாட்டி வீட்டில் இருக்கிற பாட்டியா இருக்கட்டும், அப்பையா இருக்கட்டும், மொத்தமா இருக்கட்டும், என்ன குறைந்தே கேட்பாங்க. உடனே பெண் குழந்தை சொல்லித்தான் மிக முக்கியமா கொடுத்த பிள்ளையா அப்படின்னா சரி அதையா சொல்றது. ஒரு அஞ்சு முட்டையை கொடுத்து கோழி குட்டை பொறிக்க சொன்னா அதை குஞ்சு பொறிச்சுதான் கேட்டு பாருங்க கோழி குட்டை. அப்போ உடனே என்ன சொல்லுவாரு, மகிழ்ச்சி அடையாமா வீட்டுல அந்த அஞ்சு குட்டையை கொடுத்து இந்த பொட்ட பிள்ளையாரு கேட்டாங்க பாருங்க. அவங்க எல்லாம் கோழி குஞ்சு பெட்ட குஞ்சு ரொம்ப மகிழ்ச்சி அடையாங்க. கோழி குஞ்சு பிறந்தா பெட்ட குஞ்சு, அதே மாதிரி மாடு கண்ணு போட்டா பசு மாடு பசங்கள குஞ்சு ரொம்ப மகிழ்ச்சி. ஆனா மனுஷனுக்குள்ள பிறந்தா பெண் பிறந்தா அது சமுதாயம் வந்து சொன்னார். சமுதாயத்தை மாற்றுவோம் எத்தனை பெரியார்கள் தேவை என்று நீங்க எல்லோரும் நினைச்சு பார்க்கிறேன். அதெல்லாம் மிக முக்கியமா அதே வாழ்க்கை பயன். அதனாலதான் என்சிலேயுடைய சொல்லக்கூடிய அளவுக்கு வந்தார், பெரியார்ஸ் அப்ரோச் இஸ் வெரி டிஃபரெண்ட், வெரி போல்ட், வெரி சயின்டிபிக். அந்த அப்ரோச் பிகாஸ் காஸ் கொஸ்டின் எப்படி It doesn't matter whether it is sacred laws or sacred ceremonies or whether it is God. Even Bhagavad Gita, they denigrate women. Women are God. Women and Shudras are God from off the body. This is just a slogan. Nobody could deny it. So Periyar was very straightforward in seeing. If you want to cure the disease, you will have to kill the germs. That is more important. The immunity must be developed. So that is why this is a great document. This book is a great document. This just like a Magna Carta. And when we are thinking about women, it's very different. In our university, Periyar Madhyala University, we have convened an international conference. What about Periyar's thinking, Periyar's thoughts, what kind of feminism Periyar has done it, and how to classify his ideas under particular feminism. This was the important thing. And you know, when you talk about all our learned friends, they listen in CD. Women liberators were classified as belonging to different feminist schools of thought, as liberal feminism, radical feminism, socialist feminism, anarchist feminism, cultural feminism, domestic feminism, black feminism, eco-feminism, and spiritual feminism. There are 9 classifications internationally done about feminism. But internationally assembled from various universities and the chancellor. So we have completed a special international symposium. And we were discussing around how to bring anything under this category. But Periyar feminism is very singular, very distinguishable. So among these nine categories, never to sit, because it's very unique. Because from the birth to the death, he was thinking up to the all stages. He was very original. For instance, I don't want people, I want to give time to him. Only one thing. We all know about the family plan. He was the pioneer in India. Periyar was the pioneer in India. About the birth control. Even when the other people were talking about it, Periyar's approach is very different. And you know, why the population was to control? Because they used to cite only the malnutrition theory. No, if children are more and the food supply is less, how could be divided and how is it? That was the reason. So the planning would not be there. We will have to control the only by birth control we could control the population. That was the reason, main reason they used to economic reasons. But Periyar's approach and Periyar thinking about the family plan is very unique. And very individualistic and singular. Very upset, yeah. Why should you give birth to all these business topics? And if you could have a birth control, people were completely totally against it, on the religious basis, on the belief of the, I will narrate a very incident that I was in America, there was a Jewish. A lady who is very jovially used to talk about, and he was completely 60 years old. He used to ask many questions about our India to me. He was asked this beautiful, you are heading a social movement in Tamil Nadu, India, I know that. But you are doing so many things that I have gone through the books about Periyar and about food, all these things, that is all right. But one question I would like to pose to you is, our population is wrong population. Every time you are growing and you will be outgrowing even China in 2 years, this is the problem. How could you plan it? How could you give everything to everybody? So all the population swells like everything. Are you not doing anything because you are a social worker? You want to control all this? Is it not your duty? This question was strangely put out to me. I said, okay, madam, we are doing it. Our leader was the pioneer in family planning and all. But one thing, what is then? What is the problem? Why is this going on? He was asking me once again, grilling me. I said, look here, the main problem somebody is not going is that this is. It is God given. It is God given. So God is giving all children. How can you stop it? It is God given. That is the answer. That is why we will have to do this against God, against religion, because religion is a stumbling block. God is the other reason. Then immediately she. So see, even we believe in our God. This was the answer where. And it's very stimulating and thoughtful for us. See, even we go to church, we have got our own God, but our God never multiplies this population. But tell your God, don't let him overwork, more than work. Let him not do more than work. We try to stop him. This was the jocular answer. But truth is behind it. But Periyar's approach to the birth control. Very different. And Periyar's approach is why the social side, getting children is a great burden on the mother. When the husband happens to be a drunkard, when he happens to be a gambler, when he happens to be not competent, and there is no consistency in their life, there is no happiness. They cannot come out because they say, no, what happened? I don't have any property, rights. I don't have an education, but still, he is my God. And whatever my husband says, I will have to go. Daily, he used to beat me, but I tolerate it because I cannot go out of it. Why? The children. I will have to take other children. Two or three children. I cannot take any children. Periyar has pointed out this. So, this is a social evil. So, my point of view is not very economic point, that is secondary. But basically, primary reason for the family planning is that even through the independence is being bought, their independence is being taken away. They are being slaved, not by any agency, but by their own children. Because of the children, I cannot leave the family. I love poverty. I love suffer and suffer. This is the problem. So like that, everywhere. But the widow marriage, widow marriage. So, only for ladies. That's you see, it is one way track, that's all. And the woman, chastity is only for women. We are asked, what about them? Even in our act, I suppose our judge is there. Separation of Immoral Traffic Act, that's an act. Only women are being sentenced and convicted and sentenced, not men. What for these men, this crime would not have done? Because the initiator, the murderer is men. But they both scot free. This is the gross situation. These are all pointed out by Imperial. And all this will say, justice is very important. Let it be a common thing.
There is one thing, no women to
could have any independence at any part of the age. That is, she is a child. She must be under the control of the parents. When she grows there and gets married, then she must be under the control of her husband. After getting a son, then she must be under the control and command of the son. This is Manidharma. That is quite against Manidharma. That's all. It is quite against equality. Once again, injurious to social union. This is a great social indiscrimination. This is what Periyar. That is why he has not only written, but also practiced. And in his own life, he saw the victories of his principles. That is the greatness of Periyar. That is why we carry the banner, we carry the torch that he has handed over. That is what we are doing. So, my dear young friends, kindly think, Periyar is basically never detested anybody, never discriminated anybody. Periyar wants all human beings to have equal rights, equal opportunities, equality, and empowerment. It should not be a monopoly. It should be socialized. This is the problem. And particularly, women should give more priority because now, even after our education, there were double work, double problem. They are empowered themselves. They become lecturer, they become professor, they become Aisha. When they return to their house, they become ordained their job. They have been developed, go to their kitchen. And nobody will even, they won't touch anything. You brought rasam, you brought rasam, you have done it. Oh, it is high time, oh, you are late. It is very late. We were creating so much, all these things. So she will have to burden, double burden. This is the problem. Once again, this is not a right kind of empowerment. Empowerment is equal opportunity and equal partners. When I went to Canada for citing a memorandum for our institution, we were saying, some women members used to be, we were staying in a house, it was the house landlady was there, and we used to read and write and all this. All our lecturers, they will prepare food for us and they will serve us. And that lady was observing this one. She asked, I see, are your three professors, your chancellor, your chairman, they were sitting, they were writing something, they never communicated to us, they never helped you and all this. But you know, that's the way of life in our country. But we don't allow this one. My husband will come and help me and all these things. Why you are doing that? You will have to reform all those things. Ask them to learn, give them some food also and serve you. When you are coming and you are working and all this. Same persons were our people. They go to foreign countries. They go to America. They go to other people. They are well trained there. They used to go to the kitchen. They used to prepare food and all this. But same person when we land in our country, from the Enambar to the airport, the whole thing is once again comes there. So all this is a mental shackle. Because mentally, it's a mistake. Even at times, you know, husband and wife will go. And the husband will be carrying the children when they are walking. And somebody, some friends were there immediately. He will end up why? This kind of thing. All kinds of because of the gender bias. Because she is supposed to be a book servant. Not only servant. Servant without anything. No servant could be immediately dismissed. They could be some ordinary servant could be asked to go away. But once you get married, you are a permanent servant without any pay because marriage is a very sacrament. is a sacrament. Pundarkattu. What is a Pundarkattu? It is a permanent state of practice. That is why Periyar is needed. Periyar asks the question, find the answers in your mind, not on papers, but your life.